Hello.
Hello.
Good evening, Internet.
It's us. You're you.
We've returned.
Welcome, you're friends. Here. Come and wrap your tentacles around our Pulp Cthulhu campaign, which we have dubbed the Cthulhu Files. You join us now in the fifth session of Slow Boat to China, an all-expense-paid luxury cruise to madness via Eldritch Cosmic Horror. We are Dice Lore, and this is our every other Wednesday game at 7 p.m. Pacific. We play John's Descent into Avernus campaign every Monday, and Legends of the Silent Three every other Friday with our DM, Max. I believe we are playing this Friday. Please visit us at our link tree or at dicelore.com and follow, subscribe, and watch every single minute of content we've produced over the last 2 years together.
Consume the content.
Last session, aboard the SS President Coolidge, as our heroes examined the strange tattoo gun-like device Elaine confiscated from Alex Hubbard, a small crystal shard fell from it, and, heavens to Betsy, a whole new person appeared, smack dab in the middle of Lydia's first-class cabin. This smartly dressed chap introduced himself as Franklin Dolores Francois, a wealthy artist who, it seems, had been marked by Alex Hubbard himself using the very device the gang had been perusing. Dolores seems to have been cursed to randomly jump through time, acting as bait for Hubbard to hunt the horrifying, mystical Hounds of Tyndalus. After answering a summons from the ship's captain, who assured Elaine that Hubbard was safely locked in the ship's brig, but was planning, upon making port in Honolulu, to press assault charges against her, Elaine gave her promised music lessons to Elizabeth Ann Astor. Then the group went to the mysterious Dr. Soong's cabin for tea. The good doctor was quite informative about matters mythos, and even encouraged Lydia to, shall we say, take out the trash regarding Alex Hubbard. He gave her a small metal token, which he said might offer some assistance in that regard. So, my players, did you have anything else you wished to discuss with Dr. Soong, or have you left his cabin for other pursuits? Don't forget, it is Monday, December 12th, 1933, and here aboard the SS Coolidge, that means it's casino night.
I'll follow you guys, but I'll be right back.
does anybody remember the mammoth secret password word things? We should probably try that with this guy. He might know one.
Oh. We've already tried that.
I tried that. Gosh. And then everyone made fun of me.
Including him.
He was just confused.
Well, apparently he's not. Oh, then I guess we...
We're not with the doctor anymore, right?
That's up to you. I don't know if you had anything else to talk to him about or if you left.
I'm just talking it out before we leave. Yeah, if there's nothing else, then we can walk.
I do have the phrases written down.
Okay.
I have them too, yeah.
The phraseology won't help.
The first one that we were given, which is the one that Lance. The person who was impersonating Lance.
Lance's real name is
Alain
Depardieu.
Yeah, the phrase that he would know because he was there for it, supposedly. I don't know that because I wasn't there. Every year I start my Xmas shopping later and later, and then the response is, I got mine done earlier this year. And then the ones that Professor Finch, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you guys suggested that since Lance was there for that one, maybe there should be more.
Yeah.
So he came up with some more.
Yeah, so my favorite tea shop in London is called Whitsons? Can't read my writing. White Sons. And I hear they stopped serving
I'll find them for Dark. You. Here they are.
Wow,
my favorite tea shop in London is called Whitestones. Yeah. And the response is, I hear they stopped serving Darjeeling.
Okay. And then if I'm in trouble, if it rains, I've lost my umbrella. Don't worry, I have carry too. Did the World Series last year end in 5 games or 6? I'm afraid I don't know. I was at the Open?
Opera.
Okay, so
and the
we...
one that Lance tried yeah. was...
Oh, shoes look very comfortable. Thanks. But they make my back hurt. So...
Those shoes do look very comfortable. He was right. Okay.
Not Lance. I'm sorry, Michael.
Yeah.
Onward to casino night, as some of us are very excited to gamble.
It is. Well, you leave the doctor's cabin roughly around 5 or so. Casino night gets underway at 7. We can redline straight to that if you want, or if you have anything else you'd like to do. You may do that.
Nobody's trying to pregame, right?
I'm sure Lainey needs to change into something nice or lucky.
You would be correct, Rocco.
I mean, these clowns feel like they pregame before they pregame.
Which, fair. Which clowns?
You guys.
I mean, we're
I don't drink!
The rest of you guys.
Look, I'm just trying to get into a nicer outfit.
Lydia's definitely loading up on... Like, she's kind of just checking her gear so that when she goes back out again, she knows where everything is and has everything she'll need because she's resourceful.
I mean, I've just got my sketchbook on me. Sketchbook, pencils in the pocket. Always carry that now that I've got it.
I would like to go back to my room when we can.
Would you like it if I did your face?
What?
Your face. Do you want me to put your makeup on? You're performing, right? It's a special.
Oh, not tonight. Makeup. That'll be tomorrow.
Oh, never mind then.
Actually, 2 nights hence.
You're right. I wrote the schedule down. It's 2 pages away, so I didn't flip. Yeah. 2 nights away.
Okay. Well, in that case.
You can still put my face on if you want.
I mean, I just like playing dress up. I want to look fabulous, too. But I don't have the resources at the moment. So, I'll make you look fabulous.
Yes, you can come out, hang out with me in my room.
I'll put on a little bit of rouge myself. I assume that's about nobody else's like. So, we can skip past that if you want.
Make them roll for eye makeup.
Please don't.
Make them do it.
Oh my gosh.
Are you putting Elaine's makeup on?
Yeah, I am.
Okay. Elaine, make an appearance roll.
That's like a thing?
Mm-hmm. I will take it off if it looks bad.
I hope it doesn't look bad. I'm an artist.
Wait, is appearance a real roll? Or
yeah,
is
it's,
it
up in your, it's up in your stats. At the top.
Oh, blue constitution.
Appearance.
Okay. Success.
54 out of 70. Oh, thanks the Lord. Yeah. I was about to be like, is that talking a big guy?
Thank the Lord.
She looks beautiful.
She does nice look job. Beautiful. She already was. I'm just here to accentuate those gorgeous features. Oh, shoot. He did a voice. I can't remember it now.
I fluff my curls up, do that like heavy metal rocker thing where you like make your curls more voluminous.
Sometimes you have to have thick hair.
Put on a high-waisted skirt with heels and a button-up with an over-exaggerated collar. I have my hair up, red lip as usual.
A classic. Just for, like, the sake of context, is she the only one who appearance really matters to? Like, is that part of your character?
I do have, like, planned outfits for her. So I would say, like, if we were putting everybody in order, probably.
She's a performer.
Oh, so. Oh my god, that's so cute. So. Thank you for the clarification.
Anybody else doing anything? So we're heading toward casino night now?
I would like to, I mean, we're in my room right now, right?
All of us. Watching you dress up.
Of course. Why, what else is it? I'm enjoying the free champagne that was provided to me from my trauma. And I would like to bring up that we have this strange device. Weapons are not allowed on the boat. Do we want to hide it somewhere? Do we want to keep it on our person? I just don't want to get caught with it. Do we want to throw it overboard? Like,
I'll put it on me.
Okay.
Lydia's got lots of pockets.
Were you talking about the tattoo gun?
Yes.
Why would you need to carry it?
So that no one raids our room and tries
to get it. Yeah, I'm just worried that someone's going to find it in our room while we're gone.
It's not like that monster doesn't know who might have taken it if anyone took it.
Plus, they're on the lookout for the gun that I mentioned on accident when I was telling the captain about the events. So I don't want them to come in, find this weird looking gun.
It's just, if you're worried about them finding weapons in your room, you guys were already hiding weapons.
Yeah, but this is a new weapon. Got different rules.
Well, I'm just saying, like, either you're confident those
the
weapons
rat who we got it from to try to
or you're
in.
Not.
I don't care if anybody were to find the other weapons. It's this one specifically. If what's his bucket comes looking for it, that's all.
Alex Hubbard.
That's the one.
Yeah, I'm just wondering.
I mean, you could just take it apart, right?
I could take it into pieces, or take it apart into pieces.
You're really taking out the crystal from it, right? That's what happened to the crystal? Did it break?
We showed it to the doctor, and then I would imagine I took it back, rewrapped it in my handkerchief, and put it back in my bag.
I don't think we should part from it ever. Definitely think that's something we ought to keep our hands on. But I also don't think anybody should touch it with their hands. Maybe pick it up with a hanky, keep it wrapped. I don't know. I'm concerned. I have concerns. I don't want anybody else becoming contaminated and becoming, you know, another target.
I think we should take apart...
Disarm the tattoo gun?
Yeah, well, it is disarmed, right? Because it's missing the blue crystal.
But it's still got the stabs.
The crystal fell out of a compartment in the handle. It was just being stored there.
Oh, okay.
Oh, it wasn't powered by it.
No, I assumed it was powered by it.
The crystal it contains a small amount of the blue fluid that was used to tattoo Dolores. The crystal is a device that when Dolores randomly travels through time, she automatically snaps back to wherever the crystal is. Or he.
All pronouns are fine.
So we should probably disarm it and maybe take it apart so that it's a little less inconspicuous if someone does come in. I would like to spend some time then doing that.
Mm-hmm. Well, do we want somebody else to work on that while you get ready?
Oh, I'm ready. I mean, thanks to you, I didn't have to do as much work as I usually do.
Fair.
Thank you.
I don't gamble, but I'm going to watch y'all do your thing.
Oh, I don't gamble either. It's a bad decision.
Dolores, you seem like the kind of person that gambles frequently.
You would think, but no, I like to be, I like to err on the side of caution. I'm not trying to draw too much attention to myself.
Well, I mean, you can silently roll well at a craps table. You don't have to attract attention.
Yeah,
are you that good or no?
I would just rather watch other people do it.
Who wanted to gamble?
Somebody was very high on the idea of gambling. I can't recall who.
It wasn't me.
Oh, it wasn't me. Well.
Wait, was it me? It might have actually been me.
Oh dear.
Oh, shoot. Sorry, I forgot myself.
Look at you slipping through timelines. It's like you don't even know where your mind is at half the time.
I don't.
I mean,
I mean, half the time I don't even know where I am.
Well, you are on a boat in the middle of the ocean where there happens to be gambling. Just nothing, so you know.
Nothing says you have to go to casino night. It's just an offering.
I just think the people watching is fun more than anything.
We're going to go and scout the place and ask people if they're wearing comfortable shoes or if they have umbrellas and whatnot.
I don't think it's durable. Not here.
We're meeting the person in China, right? Not here. I asked the doctor because I had a feeling. That's all.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I don't think there's anything wrong with a little gambling, but...
Attaboy.
Yeah, I just... Maybe we ought to watch the tables and see if they, they're performing up to less than fair standards.
Well, you definitely... I mean, you have to be in person for that, so I guess we'll have to go.
Well, I mean, why wouldn't we go? There's nothing else going on. It's a boring trip. I mean, I'm the most exciting.
I mean, says you since you got here. But also... Yes?
I will ask you, did you intend to try to find Alex Hubbard to do anything about him?
No, I've loaded up with things that I could do something about him with as we're going to casino night, because I do not expect to see him there, but I want to be prepared.
Now, here's a thought I have. Should we, and I don't like to split up, especially since I'm new here, but should we consider maybe going gallivanting a little bit, making ourselves just a teeny bit visible and holding the attention of anybody particularly important while a couple others go down and deal with Mr. Hubbard?
I mean, I would say if we all went and we were very obviously like making sure that we talk to a bunch of people so that we have alibis and then have somebody slip away. I mean, no one knows every single one of us well enough that they would notice. Also, I will say, Dolores, not to put you on the spot, but no one knows you're here.
Oh, well, you know, I was sleeping off a hangover for a few days in my cabin.
That was a interesting complication in that Dolores was going to be very interesting to anybody who is official on the boat, I guess. So
no, I mean that no one knows Dolores is here, therefore no one would suspect one of us.
You know, that's a good point.
As long as you don't get caught.
Yes.
True. Well, my excuse is that I came and I've been sleeping over sleeping off a hangover. So, you know.
Well, but yeah, they just
I don't think it's a terrible list. Fair. You know, that's what money's for. I don't think it's a terrible idea to go down and deal with Mr. Hubbard on my own or with one other person if somebody wanted to come with me.
I volunteer as tribute. I mean, what?
She's eager. She's willing. Well, go right ahead.
I perform hallucinogenics. If I don't know if that would show up on a test, Michael could probably attest to that. Whether or not, if I use my henbane elixirs,
Yes, they would be able. It's poison.
I mean, how advanced is toxicology in the 1930s?
Well, they're not ingesting it. They would just be inhaling it, right? So, like, I just don't know how advanced toxicology is in this time.
I mean, I think toxicology's been a very old profession.
Yeah, but not always so accurate.
Right.
Not to be that guy.
If they did an autopsy, they would probably start checking things.
That's fair.
They probably wouldn't do an autopsy until we were far and away, though.
Yeah, do we know the half-life on the drugs here? Do we know anything about them?
It's henbane. I learned about it from an old friend of ours, Gertie.
Well, if you learned about it, then it seems like something you would know. You know, how long does it last in the system? Is it detectable?
Either... an alchemy roll or a natural world roll?
Ooh,
Ooh, hard success. 10 out of 46.
Hensbane, being what it is, you're obviously you're not a a toxicology expert. Given that he's not actually ingesting it, he's only inhaling it, you feel reasonably confident that it's not going to show up in the bloodstream to an alarming degree. So to the best of your knowledge, you feel like your method of delivering the toxin would be safely untraceable to a degree.
And also, if there a lot of the staff will be busy with casino night, I would assume. But if there are staff that we need to deal with, I guess we could just pay them off, actually. That's probably better than trying to take them out, because
definitely more effective than we've been hiding bodies so many times, Elaine.
Let's not start knocking off the staff.
Yeah. So, plan of attack. I have this Hensbane potent vial that I put in a perfume bottle, and I can spray it into the individual's face. Do I know, based on that alchemy roll, if I spray it twice in their face, if it would, how much I have to give someone to just outright kill them and not roll the d4?
Yeah, you know that a small amount is going to act as a sedative. The more that you deliver, the more potential for it to be deadly there is. One or two sprays, two sprays would probably be approaching a dangerous dosage. But if you're lucky, it won't kill them.
We also were talking about doing the drowning spell.
That's probably better. I think this would be a good plan B, though.
I'd like to.
Well, you
not
could
that
use
I know anything about
with
the...
each other.
Hmm?
You could do them in conjunction. You could sedate him and then drown him.
That's a good idea.
And then make it easier to use.
Oh, I figured that was where you were going to begin with. But yes, this sounds like a lovely evening.
So. Who is going down? Because I can just give this perfume bottle to one of you. Honestly, I don't have to be the one to, give the dosage. However, I feel like I could make a big appearance. I could do an impromptu song so everyone remembers I'm there, try and distract people.
That's a good idea. You do look rather glamorous tonight.
Thank you. Aww. I could, hang on people's arms at the craps table and just...
I feel like we go do a circuit to make sure that everybody's seen us there. And then a couple of us will peel off to go see about... just to go see how Alex is doing. He must be so long.
Oh. Where does this put Dolores? Do you want Dolores to be seen or not seen?
Not seen? I think the longer no one knows they're there, the greater they are an advantage to us.
Okay. Yeah, I think you're right about that. And I look like any other guy.
Very handsome.
Oh, yeah.
True.
Beautiful.
What a dreamboat.
Any other guy. just with a particularly fabulous mustache.
Of course. I can tell that you put great care and effort into it. Okay, so we're doing this?
We're at least going as far as the casino.
Well, what is doing this? How are we getting there?
Okay, so the plan of attack. I can write it down if we want, but I'm thinking we all go to casino night, maybe not sans Dolores. You like hang in the hall or something, I don't know. We all make a circuit, make sure that a bunch of people see us, and then I will perform a big performance, like impromptu, and you, Lydia, will slip away, meet Dolores in the hall.
Oh yeah, why don't I wait, in somebody's room?
Oh yeah, there you go.
And then you can, Lydia, when you're ready, you can come grab me, you can leave under the guise that you've got a headache from all the drink.
If you hang out in my room, I can just go directly back there, so anybody watching us would see us just go back in there, or me.
Yeah, yeah, make it look like you've had a few too many drinks, and then you're going for some aspirin and anything.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm ready if y'all are.
I don't think there's anything left to do than to do it.
Let's get this show on the road, y'all.
All right.
So you're heading to casino night. Dolores is going to wait in Lydia's room.
Yes, I'll hang back. I'll have a little, just a little drink and play with my sketchbook. It's been a while. It's been a few days since I could draw.
Okay. Casino night is taking place in the first class saloon on the promenade deck. That's number 8. Right there, I'm pinging it. And as you, the group of you comes up to the door, there's a young lady at a podium saying, hello, hello, welcome to casino night. May I have your names and room numbers, please? So
Renee, as
you provide those, she finds them on her list and sort of marks them off to show that you are first class passengers and you are permitted to be there. All first class passengers are being comped $5 in chips. So she hands each of you $5 $1 chips for the casino. Please go in and enjoy yourselves.
Who's got use for this funny money? Oh wait, oh dear. Oh, I love green felt. I'm sorry. I play a lot of pool, but I love green felt, and just see this green felt. Oof.
How fun is this?
Oh no.
You got our names up.
Yeah, with your chips.
Oh my god.
So
please. You can move your chips.
How cute. Oh.
There are roulette wheels. There are craps tables. There are blackjack tables. There are slot machines. It is like a Vegas casino on the Pacific. The room is packed, and people are having a great time. There's music playing. People are allowed to smoke here. There's a haze in the air, and the drinks are flowing, and money is being lost. What are you guys going to do?
I would like to watch the roulette table and just notice the odds and probabilities that are changing as the ball lands in the places.
Sure. And that's happening.
Hmm?
That's happening. I hope you don't want to give me, you don't want me to give you like actual statistics here.
No, I don't. I have a plan. So
Rocco looks over at the blackjack table and sees there's any open seats.
There are open seats at the blackjack table. Indeed, sir.
Is there anybody notable sitting at the blackjack table at the moment?
Well, there are several blackjack tables. A couple of them are full. One of them is completely empty, actually.
Is there anybody notable that we should that we would know by name playing blackjack at the moment?
Make an intelligence roll. Just to see if you recognize anyone there.
Nope. I ain't got it tonight. Well, blackjack it is.
Nobody there that you have met before.
All right. I want to play blackjack.
Okay. Awesome. Anybody else going to play blackjack with Rocco?
Sure. I'll sit down there too.
Okay.
Michael, I hope you're good at blackjack because I don't know if I'm good or not. I'm willing to try though.
All right, let me get over here. There we go. Okay. I am gonna deal two cards to
what?
Myself, to John, and to Ryan. Okay. So, you're going to drag the two cards that you received onto the... Well, okay, you're going to place your bets first. Each chip is $1.
Okay, well, I guess the first chip is the buy-in, right?
Yeah, wherever you're sitting, just go ahead and put them in the little square. And then you want to take the cards that you were dealt, drag them onto the table near your bet, and right-click on them to flip them over.
I wanna fucking split these motherfuckers. Split it!
Wait, where did my card go?
That was my fault. Hold on, I'm just trying to figure this out myself. I think I just put it on the table. Hold on, okay. I'm gonna recall these cards. Shuffle them and redeal, okay?
My aces, no!
Sorry, man.
I could have had everything. Now my bets were nothing.
It's going to be even better. Don't worry. Okay.
Statistically.
There's your cards.
Okay.
Now I got to change my bet. Now I got to haul this shit back here.
Oh, that's not too bad, I think. Okay. So I need to just drag it to the table?
Mm-hmm. Drag it to the table, yeah.
And it disappeared. I don't see it.
It should be on the table.
Yeah, well, I don't see my queen on the table anywhere.
Aw, works really? For me.
And it's disappeared from my...
Is it right here?
It's right here. Oh, I'm stealing the card from your hand.
I don't see it. Maybe I'll try refreshing.
Is this it?
Is this your card?
I'm refreshing.
Is this your card? It's the queen of diamonds. I think we found it.
I flipped both my cards. I wasn't supposed to do that. All right.
I did that. I'm sorry.
I put a
You can control my cards?
Yeah, I've been clicking around like I'm trying to steal one of John's cards. It literally lets me look into his hand and then
I'm recalling again.
Stealing. Do it.
This may be a bust. Let's see. All right. Nobody touch anyone's cards but their own.
Got it.
Control yourselves.
I'm just playing around. Luckily for me, I've had functionality through all this, and I've been able to play each one. And when I turned over two aces, I was like, please let me play this hand, please.
Okay, so am I supposed to, after I open up the cards in my hand, am I supposed to click and drag the card onto the board?
Yes, you drag the card onto individually. The table.
And then individually. And then I should be able to see it on the board. Because every time I've done that, the card just looks like it there disappeared. It is.
These are mine. I put mine into play.
Any cards on the board?
I'm still refresh roll 20?
I just refreshed roll 20.
Oh, shit. Might not work for John.
All right. They're still in your hand, John?
They're still in the hand right now.
Yeah, I see them there. You can't drag them?
If I drag them, they just disappear and they go invisible.
I can try.
Like,
you can't get them out of his hand
right now?
I can't anymore. Before, I was able to select your tokens and pull them out, but now it's not allowing me to do anything.
Right. Were you guys saying that there are cards on the board right now?
Yes, there were.
Gonna do.
Because I've never seen a card on the board, so...
That's where there I you is. Go.
Okay.
That's Jones.
Okay.
I don't see any.
All right, John, you've been dealt a 10. I've been dealt a 6.
You don't see the cards, John?
No.
I see blackjack activated in the bottom right corner, so it's an app that's running currently, is my guess, or it's just the deck.
It's the deck to draw from, I think.
Yeah, that's it. And it looks like it should be working.
Are you seeing my cards, John?
No.
You're seeing
he's not
cards.
Seeing anything on the blackjack table. Okay, so do we want to just... I can play with you, so we can play a hand out, and John can bet on my hand if he wants.
Okay. So there's your two cards, Ryan.
Okay.
And there's John's two cards.
So a 16 and a 20 for me. I'm going to stay with a 20.
Okay. John, you have a 16.
I have a 16.
Yes. Are you going to stand or do you want me to hit you? I have a 7 showing. Dealer stands on 17. So if my other card's a 10, you lose.
Sure, hit me.
Michael Harris.
Ooh.
Not bad, not 20. Bad.
I'm at 20 now?
Mm-hmm. 19.
Wait, what?
Yeah, I'm sorry. 19, 19, yes.
I'm at 19. Okay.
Yes.
Yeah.
I will stay at 19.
Okay. So the dealer.
Taylor's got 10. Uh-oh. No, damn 20. It. I'll take my money back. Thank you.
So that's a push for Rocco. And Michael loses on that hand.
Okay. Oh, that was.
So you lost $3?
$3?
Did you put $3 down?
No,
I put one.
You only had one in? Okay.
Yeah, we each put one down.
Yeah, I moved my tokens down here, but I only have one on the table. So
I have the orange tokens and John.
Oh,
has
you're the orange. Tokens. Okay, yeah. Okay. Okay, I had it backwards.
Do we want to try another game, or does anybody else want to try? Or roulette would be easier, I think.
Anyone?
Here's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to game the game, right? So can I make like an intelligence check to gather whether or not I have watched it long enough to have a pretty good idea of what's going to happen next?
What are you talking about?
You know how to do this.
Haley wants to try and count cards. Like yeah. She wants to roll a dice to see if she can count cards right now. That's what she wants.
That was a thing that happened in more recent times, right? Like that was like in the 80s or 90s.
No, it's roulette. It's like, isn't it just watching the little ball go around and land
in a spot? Count cards. Or who? Huh? Someone said count cards.
You're watching the roulette wheel.
I'm not trying to do that necessarily, but like I'm just trying to keep track of how many go in a red spot and how many go in a black spot. Like I don't feel like that is like so like modern that it's insane. Like probability's been around for a while.
Okay, I don't know what to do with that.
If it helps, I'm not going to try and use it to gain my own benefit. I'm going to try and flirt
with somebody.
I don't
know how you would. Okay.
She could just roll to see if her cheating worked or not.
Yeah.
I could just. I don't want to roll luck. I'm not going to suggest that.
Because
I feel like it's intelligence. I would have to know.
Make an intelligence roll.
Intelligence. It's a random result.
She thinks she knows.
I failed. So if I don't think I have a good idea, then I'm going to keep watching.
The red is coming up more often than black.
Okay. All
Are there any handsome men playing at the table? Or handsome anybody's, I guess?
Sure. There's a bunch of people playing at the table.
Like how I'm like trying to flirt and my hair looks like a freaking crow's. Okay.
Do you want to sidle up to somebody?
I would like to go up behind somebody.
Mm-hmm.
And I would like to just whisper in their ear, "You should bet on black."
Oh, hello there, young lady. Really? Why do you think that?
Gut feeling.
Really? Bet on black. Okay. I can do that. So he will take his chip. I'm going to take one of Dolores's chips. Do you mean just straight black?
Yeah, why not?
All right. You gonna make a bet?
Do I?
Mm-hmm.
Sure, why not? I'll throw a chip in.
Okay, go ahead.
Oh, right. Oh.
I got this thing on this row. This row right here feels good. This is a good row. I'm feeling this row. I think this row could do it.
Honestly, 90% of my roulette knowledge comes from Persona 5. So,
all right. So we have, oh, a bet on the whole row. We have a bet on 13 black, and we have two bets on black. All right. Any more
Everybody's
bets?
Everybody's going in.
Any more bets? That's all the bets. We are going to roll now. The wheel spins.
Yes!
Three,
I knew the
black.
Three! Yes! I knew it was the three! I did it! 10 to 1, give me 10.
You gotta keep track of your own winnings here.
I broke even, so I got 15. That's more than all you. Maybe. Even money. Oh, wait. Yeah. No, I do.
Yeah, even money on black. So you each won a dollar on that. Rocco won 10 bucks.
Way to go, Rocco.
Any more bets going down?
That's good money.
So did I get one?
Mm-hmm. You get your chip back and you get another chip. So you won a dollar.
Oh, I see it. Wait. So shouldn't I have 6 then?
I'm not giving you more tokens. You just have to keep
track. Oh, sorry. You said that. My bad. I didn't understand what you meant at the moment.
The chat in Roll 20 is the catalog, so improving to the catalog. Okay,
hey,
I felt 3.
You were right, little lady. Nice job. Hey, buddy, he says to Rocco. It's Rupert Cocksure, the gentleman you met at breakfast the other morning.
Cocksure! Hey, buddy!
What's up? We were going to play shuffleboard. What happened?
Oh, you know what? I completely ran out of zinc oxide for my face. I burned so easily. I didn't want to go out and play shuffleboard.
Damn, I don't know where Rosie's at. My wife, Rosie, she loved you. She loved meeting you.
Oh,
she'd
is
be
that
so happy
so
to see
you're
here. Old.
You don't say. That's awfully kind. Thank
yeah,
you.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. This pretty lady here just gave me a good tip.
She did.
Yeah, I think she might know what's going on here.
Yeah, as a married man, I don't know how many other tips you should be taking from other ladies, but you know, you do you.
Believe me, Rosie's here somewhere. I'm just taking her advice on the bets, and it paid off. Hey, lady, should I bet black again?
Can I roll an intelligence check?
You? Whatever. Yeah,
you can't cheat this. You gotta make a decision.
He's literally rolling a d20, Haley.
Yep. Go ahead. Make your intelligence check.
6
Mm-hmm. 8 red. It's gonna come up 8 red.
Okay, fair enough. I didn't realize exactly how it was going to work, so I had this idea in my head of how this was going to go, and this is different, so that's fine.
Are you telling Rupert to bet on 8 red?
No, I'm telling him to bet on red.
All right. If you get any more, like, specific, visions of what's going to happen, please let me know.
Go for one for 1 to 10. Why not?
Huh? What?
Oh no, that's the same as betting on red. Never mind. I'm like, how does this game work? Right.
No, 1 to 10 is 1 through 10.
Yeah, but it pays the same amount of money.
Same. As yeah.
Betting on red or wait. Black.
So Ryan bet on a row and he got 9 up.
Yeah, it's 10 to 1 if you bet on the row straight up.
So if I did this...
So he's going to take your advice too.
No, but...
And he's going to bet on 1 to 10 as well.
Okay.
There you go.
Oh, wow.
Lee, yeah. I think I may have found a bug in your game.
You may have. How about that?
Wait. Playtesting. Here we go. Rocco has gotten eye level with the felt table and has made a pyramid out of his chips and is not paying attention.
You may hit on this, John.
I don't think so.
Well, it's just impossible. I lose 4 and I gain 9.
Good point.
Right. So I'm. Yeah. I.
Any more bets? Round and round she goes. Where she stops.
I'm nobody betting on red 14. Oh, Jesus.
1 black. Oh, lady.
Crit fail.
I guess one. You lost your magic. He did get 1 for the 1 through 10. Michael
didn't
wins 10
bucks.
Didn't
lose any money.
Yeah, I'm at 10 now. Sure. Obviously, this doesn't work, right? Like... There's no way that this would be a thing in a roulette table at a casino.
Mike, you take the fun out of everything. We're just trying to have a good time, and here you are. We're on an accursed boat full of stinky things and bugs, and all we get is this nice felt table and a nice good time to play games, and all you can do is overanalyze it. You leave it alone. Leave it alone. Something good. We're going to enjoy it. I got oh, these aren't really money. Okay,
this is Colin speaking, not Michael.
What?
I don't know.
Rocco's ready to cash out.
Yeah, Rupert walks away from the table looking for Rosie.
I'll say I'm just up 10, and I'll be done. I'm not going to sit here until I gain like $1,000.
No?
House is going to notice at that point. Oh, look who's smart, huh?
I'm going to go to the craps table and go stand next to the person with the biggest pile of money.
Okay.
You just like quadruple your money every time?
What?
Or you double it?
What are you talking
about? You quadruple it. Oh, because like if I spend 5, I go up to 10.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so I double it every time. And I just put 2 chips down the next time. Go up to 20. So on.
That's fine. You ruined the game for everyone.
Yeah, that's great. Play right, too many PlayStation roulette gambling games.
There's an older lady at the craps table that has the largest pile of money there.
Oh, that's so one of my grandmas.
You see, Janelle is like a wild card. Like she rolls in and she like crushes the game. And then you've got Phyllis, who's like very quiet and calculating, very smooth with all of her moves.
It's true. I don't think Renee gambles. Anyway.
Renee loves plants. Fuck gambling.
True. Okay. I'm just gonna, every time someone wins, I'm gonna go over to them and just be like, woo!
Okay.
I'm just trying to make an impression on a bunch of people. Like,
oh, is that
I'm
what you're doing? Oh, okay. Creative. Very good, very good. So. Anybody playing craps? No craps for anyone? Okay. Okay, so Elaine is making a spectacle of herself every time someone wins.
Yeah, pretty much. Pretty much. That's my plan.
And unless anyone else wants to do anything, I can move into the part where I go and try and entertain.
Are you doing that tonight?
Well, it's the distraction.
Okay, but you had tonight that you were gonna play, right?
Yeah, that's the 14th.
At the Tahitian Ball. Yeah.
2 days.
Mm-hmm. Okay, there's a band in the corner.
Okay. I guess I'll wait till they're done with the song and then go whisper in the ear of the... Is there a singer? Or is it just
currently, that's just music. Just instrumental. It's like a small sort of jazz combo.
Okay. But there's microphones, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'm going to go up to one of them.
There's a conductor.
A conductor? Oh. Mm-hmm. Oh.
He'll make an announcement every once in a while in his microphone. And he's directing them, and he'll turn around and like smile at everyone.
So I guess I'll go up to the conductor and ask... Is it okay if I perform the song that I've been rehearsing for the Tahitian Ball tonight?
Ooh, like a little preview for everyone?
Exactly, like a little preview, darling. Wouldn't that be fun?
A wonderful thing. Yes, we love to have our passengers come forward and perform with us. That'd be great. Yes, of course.
I can't wait. Just let me know. Give me a cue, and I will be there.
We will be done in 7 bars.
I know what that means, because I'm a singer.
What's your name, my dear?
My name is Renee.
Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you're enjoying your evening here on the Dollar Line Cruise on the SS President Coolidge. We love having you here. We hope you're winning lots and lots of money. And now, one of your fellow passengers, the beautiful and talented Renee Lestrange, would like to perform for you. What are we doing, my dear?
I'm going to do the sultry soft Minnie the Moocher because I've practiced it.
We know that. A 1, 2, 1, 2, 3.
Okay. Roll singer. I'm not going to actually sing it myself. Man. Oh my god. But can I like roll with a bonus roll because I like was practicing?
You didn't practice this one, did you?
I practiced it with Elizabeth.
You did?
And in my room.
You did practice it, and we did say it would give you a bonus roll when performing because you practiced it and you succeeded at your practice. You get a bonus die.
Okay. I'm just going to roll it again. Or should I roll a d10 because it's not giving me the bonus penalty
roll
box.
A d10. There's some static feedback from the microphone as you start.
Okay. Okay.
But you overcome the initial awkwardness. And what's 60? It's 69. Well done.
That's the awkwardness you've overcome.
Sexuality and femininity, and I am...
That's a regular success, so... Well, yeah. So some people actually come and gather around, and like, you know, because Minnie the Moocher involves the whole hidey, hidey, hi, right? Hidey, hidey, hidey thing. Some people actually start to sing along with you.
Oh.
And when you finish... There's applause. The room in general is pretty much ignoring you, but some folks gathered around. You're like, my dear, that was lovely. Well done.
I would love to do another number later in the evening if you'd like.
Oh, please come back. We're here till 9.
Wonderful. Thank you.
A 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, and they burst into the next number.
Excellent.
That was great. You did great. I saw the whole thing. You were marvelous. Good job.
What were the other three of you doing while Elaine was performing? Were you just watching? Rocco, Michael, and Lydia.
Yeah.
I was making kind of a circuitous circle, kind of looking for people I know to say hello to.
Mm-hmm.
I probably have a cocktail, you know, just kind of mingling as a means of cashing the joint.
Make a spot hidden roll.
Oh, thank goodness.
Regular success. Sheesh.
I'll take it.
As you were sort of casing the room, from the entrance, sort of pushing through people and jostling, and looking somewhat distressed, perhaps, is Takeshi Sirota, who you had met before, the gentleman that Elaine had breakfast with.
Yeah.
A Japanese gentleman. His hair is a little mussed, and he's got sort of a distressed look on his face as he's pushing through people through the room, and every once in a while he kind of glances back over his shoulder.
I move towards him.
Okay. Do you intercept him?
Yeah, or I like kind of take pace with him so that I don't interfere with his expedient movement, but
okay.
He
takes no notice of you.
What was his name again?
Takeshi?
Takeshi! Takeshi-san, are you all right? What's wrong?
Yeah, I'm fine. How are you?
Where's the fire, buddy?
I've got someplace I need to be. I will talk with you later. And he tries to move past you.
Well, wait. What is something happening? Does this have to do with Dolores?
He's looking around. Who?
Who are you running from?
Who is Dolores?
The gentleman who joined us at tea.
What?
You are conflating people.
This is not Dr. Soong.
Oh, am I?
The single man who Elaine wondered if was kind of creepy because she met him at breakfast. And,
gotcha. I let him pass then.
He was very happy meet all of you, though. He's just a really friendly guy.
Yeah. Yeah. I let him go, but I watch where he goes.
He's in the jewel trade.
Yeah.
You remember you had discussions with him. So you let him go? Okay.
I let him go and fall back a little bit, and then I'm going to see where he goes.
He pushes through the room and keeps going through people and actually heads toward the staff doors in the back that kind of lead back into the back area with the staff.
Let's see. Lydia's up on doing her thing.
You're Lydia.
I am Lydia. Dang it, we did it again. Anyway, let's see. Elaine is doing her thing. I don't know where John's character is right now. Did you come into the... I guess you're at the gambling tables.
Yeah, probably somewhere around wherever Rocco. Yeah.
Okay, so does he go into the staff doors?
You watch him until to see where he goes. Yes, he goes through the doors.
Okay. Dang, Dolores is in my room. I'm gonna see if I can grab John. I can't remember your character's name right now.
Michael.
Chadwick. Not Chadwick. What was it?
Is it Keaton or something like that?
Yes. Michael
as Keaton. Keaton.
John is playing Michael as Keaton. John, formerly Lance, is playing Michael as Keaton.
Thanks for that. Super helps. John's character. I'm going to kind of catch him by the elbow at whatever tables he's at. And he says, hey, something's up with, I can't do names tonight, guys. It's just not happening.
Takeshi Sirota.
Something is up with Takeshi Sirota. Like, do you think we should follow him? He's acting real shifty, not like he was this morning.
We can keep an eye on him.
Well, he went back into the staff area. Do you think we should follow him, or do you think we should? It was very suspicious.
That is odd.
Well, I'm going after him then.
Sure. Did you want somebody with you, or did you want to go solo?
I mean, two people are better than one, but one person's less conspicuous going through staff doors. I'll come back out if I need help. I'll try to assess the situation from there.
Okay.
But keep an eye out. If I'm not back in 5 minutes, maybe start meandering that way.
What's Rocco doing?
Rocco is hanging out with Elaine post-performance.
Okay. So, Lydia, you're just going to head back through the staff doors the way Takeshi went.
Yeah, I mean, I'm going to try to keep my distance enough. I'll actually grab some red wine and kind of splash it on myself and move towards the staff entrance and asking if folks have any soda water.
Okay, okay.
So I go inside, and as soon as I'm kind of like let in, I look for him.
Yeah, there's some serving staff back there. You know, there's a sink and a dishwashing area, and this is where like all the glassware is coming back through. And there are a number of staff members. They don't really pay much attention to you. As you come back and you're asking for someone to help with the spill.
That was to get through the door. Okay. Wasn't necessarily.
Okay. Yeah. So they're kind of bustling around back there. And
do I see him?
There's no sign of him. Now, you kind of talked to Michael and you gave him some time and you don't know where he went. And you don't know your way around back there. So you're not sure where it lets out to.
Yeah. I'm trying to remember if you know any more about this gentleman.
At this point, another passenger pushes through the doors and kind of moves past you. Make an intelligence roll.
Oh, no. Oh, thank goodness.
You recognize him as a man who the morning... I believe it was this same morning. You and Rocco and I don't remember if you all went. It's where Elaine met Phyllis Barnes and talked about putting shrimp in the Bloody Mary. And you and Rocco just kind of listened around to the staff to see if you could pick up any scuttlebutt. There was a man sort of in a corner booth, very sharply dressed in a suit with a you know, his tie, neatly tied, very, very buttoned down gentleman. Looked very lost in his own thoughts, very unfriendly. Sort of like in a pinstripe, like Chicago suit.
And he just kind of rushes past.
You didn't talk to him at the time. You just noted that he looked very sort of, you know, introspective and almost angry, really. So he brushes past you and continues on through the room without looking at anyone or talking to anyone.
And does he go through another door, or do I just lose sight of him if I don't follow him?
He heads back through. There's some shelving with some crates, you know, bottles in them.
Okay.
And there is actually another door that heads out of the room back behind those crates.
Okay. I'm going to keep following him sneakily. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of hustle and bustle.
There is. Let me see. So, that actually lets out into the Grand Salon, which is like a large dining area that has a big stage in the middle. It's empty right now. But... he heads into there and heads through the tables. The room's fairly dark. It's not in use at the moment.
And he's just making a beeline.
And he is making his way to the doors in the back of that room. He is casting about in the room as he goes.
Okay, I'm going to try to stay in the darkest parts of the shadow and just creep along the wall then. Just keep watching.
Make a
towards
stealth,
that door.
Stealth roll.
Let me find where my stealth is. Oh, there it is. No!
Is a critical failure.
I kick over a vase.
Yep, as you head through the shadows, your foot actually catches on a chair that's pushed in at a table. You trip, the chair flips up, it bangs under the table, falls onto its side, and he's about halfway through the room at this point. He hears you and he turns around and he's like, "What the fuck? Who are you? What are you doing?" And he starts heading in your direction.
As soon as the noise started happening, I ducked under the tablecloth.
All right, come out of there. Come out of there, you little shit. Come on.
I don't make any noise, but I do draw a pistol.
He pulls the tablecloth away. The tables are all draped in white tablecloth and sort of pulls it aside and looks under you, at you. You notice that he is holding a pistol pointed at you as you hide under the table. What are you doing under there? Who are you?
Shit, you're not this isn't the restroom at all.
Fuck. And he turns.
I'm so sorry. I am so lost.
I don't care. And he moves.
Can you?
He continues back in the direction he was going.
Okay. And I kind of toddle off that whole situation. And then kind of seem as though to faint for a few minutes. Or pass out or whatever. Like, I know he's not paying attention to me anymore, but I don't want to give him a reason to turn around.
He's moved through the room.
Okay, and he's through those doors already.
He's through the other doors.
Okay. I'm going to get up and I'm going to scoot along until I'm at least next to the door. I don't know that I'm going to go in, but I want to see if I can hear anything.
Okay, make a listen roll.
No! I'm a librarian, doggone it.
You hear the sound of the commotion and the music distantly from the casino room, kind of echoing in this big empty room right now. Through the next doors. Let's see, that is... No, it's just another part of the Grand Salon. Yeah, so no sound coming from there.
Can I just kind of... Are they push doors?
Mm-hmm. Kind of...
Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to crouch and just kind of like push it open a little bit to see if I can hear anything. I'm not going to push it so far as to look like open.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm going to try to listen harder and then see if I can hear anything.
From where you are, you can see on the sort of diagonally to the wall, the side wall, there is a door that leads out onto the decks from there. And that door is just closing, just coming to a close as you glance.
Okay, and sorry, what was the orientation of where that door went?
I'm going to ping it. It's right about there.
Where did you ping it?
Oh, I'm pinging it. The casino's still up. Okay. sorry. Let me move this to there.
There we go.
And it's right around here.
Okay, so that door looks like it should lead outside.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And where did we start? Where was the casino night? Is it here at 8?
Mm-hmm, right there. You came through here. This is where you hid behind a table. He went through this door, and there is another door here that he went out.
Okay. I am going to go back the way I came. I'm going to get back into casino night and see what other folks are doing.
Okay. What are other folks
doing? To see if I can grab anybody to help me follow, because I think it's dangerous to go alone.
Elaine is in the bathroom currently trying to hype herself up in the mirror to give a better performance next time.
Rocco is waiting outside of the women's bathroom, not trying to look like a creep, but waiting for her to come back out.
Probably just keeping an eye for whenever you return.
Yeah, so... Okay, and then Dolores is still in my room. Okay, so I'm gonna go back to Michael and be like, hey, okay, so we went through several doors. It's not just Takashi, it's another gentleman that I recognize from when me and Rocco were walking around earlier. Everybody's going somewhere pretty urgently. I even made a bunch of noise and they didn't really stop. Do you want to help me go after him or what?
Who are we
looking I need backup for? Here. There's just a lot of suspicious activity with Takashi and this other gentleman who I recognize as being a passenger on this boat. But I don't know where they're going. They went out onto the deck again, sort of down at the starboard side. Whatever end of the boat that is. The tail of the boat.
Port.
Front of the boat?
The tail of the boat would be the stern.
Yes. It goes to the outside of the boat. That's as far as we're getting in the description here, dude.
Starboard's the right side, port is the left side.
Gotcha. Okay, well, regardless of those terms, he went out that way. And I don't know if we should follow him. I feel like it's connected to a lot of the other weird stuff that's been going on here. I don't know where Elaine and Rocco are right now, but...
This... You don't know who this other person is? The second person? Sorry.
When you me and Rocco were wandering...
Yeah.
Takashi passed and I didn't see where he went. And then another gentleman who I've seen as another passenger on this boat went out the same direction. So something weird's going on, and I want to see if we should be worried about it.
Okay, but you don't know who this other guy is.
No, but he was a couple decks below when Rocco and I saw him. He didn't look like a light-hearted gentleman, if you know what I mean.
I'm trying to figure that out.
Okay, I think my point is there are several men going through unconventional pathways towards potentially suspicious activity, so driven are they to this purpose. So if that doesn't sound weird to you, then I'll just send you. But otherwise, if we want to keep our friends safe and keep Dolores safe from being poached by this monster, then I'd say we should go figure out what that is, and if there's something bad happening, we should stop it.
Sorry, how does Dolores factor in? Why are you suspicious that something's going to happen to Dolores?
Oh my god, I leave him. I walk over to Rocco. Rocco!
Yes!
I have Rocco, no idea where you're trying to go with this thread, to be like perfectly honest. I'm not following. With me.
What's going on, Lydia? I'm waiting for Lady to come out of the bathroom. She looked like she needed help. What do you need?
Oh no, did she finish her songs? Is she free again?
Yeah, she finished. She's just, you know, in the toilet, and I thought I'd wait and console her if she came
out. Okay. Do you remember Takashi that she had breakfast with this morning?
Yeah, that guy. Yeah, I remember.
Yeah. I just he bumped into me on his way out to he went back through the staff exit.
Oh.
And I asked him where he was going, and he wouldn't tell me. And then also, you know when we were passing through that one space with all those people, there was that one guy.
With the thing.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, that one. Yeah, I remember.
Yeah. He bumped into me when I was trying to follow Takashi. So everybody's going. There's now two people that I'm certain are going to a place with potentially ill will. And what do you think?
I'll back you up. If you need help, I'm sure Lainey's gonna be fine. I think.
Well, I want to go see if she's ready to rock and roll here because okay. I don't like it.
Yeah, you should go. So check
I go.
It,
I. Enter the ladies and recount exactly the same thing to Elaine and say, do you think we should go after him?
She's in the mirror going, you got this. You can do this. Just sing like your heart.
Elaine.
Huh?
There's weird stuff going on. You want to come?
No.
You going to perform or are you going to come with me?
Do you want me to perform? I told the guy I would, but I don't really give a hoot what he thinks.
Well, there's Takashi, the gentleman you had breakfast with this morning, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And then also, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera.
Whoa.
Yeah. So, spooky bollocks are fallen down. And do you want to come see if there's something we should be interested in? Should we go make trouble?
We could.
I can't go by myself. I'm pretty sure that one of those guys could take me. I'm not that big a person. So.
I can definitely go with you. I'm not armed to the teeth at the moment, but
That's okay. I mean, strength in numbers to begin with, right?
I just, I think I would just have left the house with a perfume bottle, because that was part of the plan. And then maybe, yeah. Like...
Where is... Do I know where the brig is in relation to where I am right now? Nobody knows where the brig is? Mm-mm. Okay. Okay,
That there are house phones throughout the ship if you would need to get in touch with Dolores. I'm just saying, you know your room number. You could always use a house phone to call. Just giving you that.
Oh, good heavens. This changes everything. In that case, I go, let's see. Are there house phones in the casino? I'll go find somewhere where there's a quiet house phone.
Sure. You find one out in the hallway.
Yeah. The situation to Dolores.
Does Dolores answer your phone?
I don't know. Do they?
Ring, ring, ring.
Okay, on the one hand, my concern is that if I answer it, they're going to be like, well, who the fuck is that? But my other answer can, like, I'm worried that it's going to be one of you guys, but I feel like it's going to be suspicious. But, okay, I'll be brave. I'll answer it.
Dolores, it's me, Lydia.
Oh, Lydia, what's going on?
Okay, nothing actually, but I have seen it was only Alex that you recognized on this boat, is that right?
Yeah, that's the only one.
That wouldn't make any sense otherwise. Okay, so I just saw a couple of spooks heading out towards the going out a secret exit, as it were. And I don't know if it's connected to the weird stuff that happened that brought you here with us today, but really, I'm running out of people to try to convince to come down to wherever they. I don't have any partners to go chase this with.
I mean, are you sure? Are you sure it's something you'll want to go chase right now? I don't know that I'll be of much use on my own. I feel like we should have. Maybe somebody who's been on the ship for more than...
You know what? You're not wrong there. You're not wrong. Okay. I'll call... I'm going to go do a little further investigating, and I'll call you later.
Just stay safe.
I will. Don't worry. I've got a gun.
Okie dokie.
Okay. So I hang up. I'm going to go out the side door as under the guise of a lady who needs to get air. So I'll go out... I don't know if you can see when I'm doing stuff here, but I'll go out of one of the exits on the number 8 spot. So,
sure.
And I go kind of over the railing. Well, I didn't know. I wasn't getting any. Yes, for now I am.
Well, I was trying to say that she wants to go with you, but like she doesn't have. Her normal slew of stuff, which is all I was trying
then
to
do. I'll just tell Elaine that if I'm not back in like 30 minutes that she should assume I'm in trouble.
I'll go outside with you, and so I can just be present and listen and watch.
Oh, perfect. That's great. Yeah. Let's go be two, you know, ladies who have overindulged, and we'll see if we can see them from where we go.
I'm gonna smoke a cigarette.
Sounds good to me. So we go do that. I'm sure I've lost them by now, but I do kind of look around to see if I can see them or see anything unusual out in the silent ocean.
Roll spot hidden just to see what you see.
Boop. Nope, Lydia's back.
Can I also look?
Yeah, yeah.
I know that she told me.
Mm-hmm.
1989. Success.
I will say, like, Michael's probably been following you behind. You like made him very confused, and he asked you a question, and then you just ran away from him.
Well, sometimes that's how Lydia's do.
Sometimes that is how Lydia's do.
So, anyways, Michael is kind of trailing you guys. Not
right,
trying to be hidden from you guys, but probably catches up to you at this point.
Rocco is slowly, quietly following behind Michael.
I'm kind of the Pied Piper of this cursed ship.
It's a Scooby-Doo and the Mystery Crew, like, creeping down
perfect. All the way.
Out on the deck, you see the moon shining beautifully off the Pacific Ocean as you romantic. Churn through it. The ocean is flat and calm. Perhaps in the moonlight, there are some dolphins jumping.
good grief.
There are various people taking a stroll around the promenade deck. However,
at least the Frank Ocean, y'all.
Oh, I have a bonus on spot hidden rolls. Sorry, can I just roll
it's
that?
It's fine. Go ahead.
Okay. A one. So mm-hmm. It's the same roll.
Same thing. Cool. Lydia is not sure if she's able to spot them or not. Elaine, you're quite certain that you don't see Takeshi Sirota or anyone behaving strangely.
I don't see Takeshi or anyone. All I saw were some really beautiful dolphins.
Curse you, trapper keeper. Okay, well, that was weird. Thanks for coming out here with me, Elaine.
Of course. Good excuse.
Lydia's a little discouraged.
Hmm?
I said Lydia's a little discouraged because she was pretty sure that she still feels pretty uneasy about it, but there's nothing for it at the moment.
Do you?
And she's pretty sure that nobody really is. What?
Do you want to go further towards where you saw them exit, or?
Yeah, maybe we just do a lap, see if anything jumps out at us.
Just going for a walk.
Promenading and whatnot, as ladies do.
Are Michael and Rocco trying to remain stealthy as they follow?
I'm not trying to be stealthy. What are you? Who are you looking for?
So do you catch up with them?
Yeah.
Okay.
I told you, I'm looking for Takeshi or that other gentleman.
That other gentleman is a very apt description.
Don't we need? Well, we had a plan tonight. Don't we need to kind of take care of that?
All right. That was just. I'm just keeping my eyes open.
Trouble, and I don't know where that came from.
Oh boy, I don't have the time to explain myself. Let's go kill someone.
Rocco, what are you doing?
Rocco still got his chips in his hands, and he just kind of looks up from them and be like, I don't want to kill anybody tonight.
Okay, meta, for the sake of clarification, exactly why is it like you just have a hunch that we need to pay attention to them and follow them, or was it more to that? Because I haven't been able to super consistently follow the train of thought.
That's okay. I barely know what I'm saying, too.
It's jazz, baby. Jazz.
Oh, boy. It's jazz night, y'all. Yeah. I am the solo saxophone. Anyway. I thought it was odd that not one but two people were exiting through the staff exit, and they seemed pretty focused / distracted with whatever their mission is, and that reads as suspicious, possibly possessed. Like, we've seen enough weird stuff that Lydia's weird stuff o-meter is pretty.
This is sussy.
Well, yeah, basically. She sees shadows everywhere, so, I mean, as can be expected from her line of work.
Well, so, if something weird is going to happen, maybe now's the perfect opportunity to take advantage of the weirdness.
That's the most astute things you've said all evening, Michael. Thank you for that insight.
Yeah, we have insight to give insight.
Anyway.
Dolores, are you doing anything in particular in the room? Or are you just...
I mean, I've just been, sipping a little bubbly, drawing some pretty people.
Killing time.
You know, waiting for a phone call, feeling myself finally kill that son of a bitch.
You said there's nobody else out here, right?
There are other people.
Okay.
Strolling around, enjoying the view, enjoying the evening.
Are we going to do this? Do we want to do this?
I think we should still do this. I don't know.
Oh, yeah, Lydia's fine. Like, okay, so no one else thinks that was weird, but I'll holler if I see anything else. All right.
It was definitely weird.
I'm not saying it wasn't weird.
Anyway, let's move on. To murder!
So how about you call Dolores, tell them to come down. I will go and try and perform again and see if I can bring the house down. And if that all works, I hand Lydia the perfume bottle.
Excellent.
One spritz for hallucinogenic, probably, maybe. Two could be fatal. Give it to Dolores if you're not comfortable or if you just want to do the whole thing yourself.
I mean, it couldn't have happened to a better person.
Hmm?
I said it couldn't have happened to a better person. So, thank you for this. Let's go, break a leg.
Thank you.
Then I guess I'll go pick up Dolores and, we'll shuffle on down to Murder Town together.
So you head back to the phone or you head back to your cabin?
I think I head back to the cabin to pick up Dolores and then establish a plan probably of how to get down there. Like, basically, do we just keep following stairs all the way down as far as we can go?
I mean, we don't know where the brig is.
What are the gentlemen going to do?
Well, Mr. Harris, what should we do?
You guys should hype the crowd.
I don't want to do that. I understand we need to make a distraction, but I don't want to be the center of that.
Well, we still need to find where the brig is.
That is true.
It's probably the first thing we should do. I mean, if nothing else, we can be a second adjacent orbiting party to Lydia and Dolores, right? We can run interference from the side.
Sounds good to me. Means. So, yeah.
Hey. The other day, you weren't feeling so great from something you ate, right?
That's correct, yes. I do have a very weak constitution.
Can you replicate that easily?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I used to do it all the time. It's how I got a lot of free meals.
You know, to make a mess.
Oh, yeah, I can make a mess easy. No problem. Yeah, I
got you, Kevin. Yeah, that might be a good way to create an opening then.
All right. Sounds good to me. I'll mess it up real good.
Can you hit somebody with it?
Ooh. That's a trajectory, maybe. I mean, back when me and my brothers and sisters used to fight, yeah, we got pretty good at it.
Yeah, it's just if you could regurgitate on somebody, that would be a great way to get them out of the picture for a moment. Could blame it to seasickness, to too much drinking, whatever, right? But
oh yeah, I mean, luckily there won't be any drink on my breath. But yeah, I'll just say it was the shrimp.
Okay.
So are you two going with Lydia back to the cabin to get Dolores?
We'll orbit around them.
Okay. And Elaine's going back in to perform again.
Sure.
I don't have to do that. I just...
I mean, you've been pretty insistent on doing it.
Well, only because it didn't work the first time. Like, I was hoping to get, the whole room, watching. It was just a regular success. So, I don't have to do that. I could just join you guys.
I don't
want to be left alone at casino night either. Right? So, maybe I just go with you guys at this point.
Well, didn't you say that you were going to perform?
I did.
So if you disappear?
It'd be weird.
It's okay. Like you're scheduled to go on. You just offered that you might come back. And
I didn't.
He said whenever you want.
So they're heading down to the brig or trying to figure out where the brig is. I'm trying to think of how you could ask a staff member where the brig is without asking a staff member where the brig is.
So we'll say Lydia has gotten back to the room and gathered up Dolores. The gents are just kind of trailing behind, and Elaine, I don't know what you decided ultimately to do.
I guess I'm... I don't know.
Rocco, how good are you at acting?
Terrible. I mean, if you know me, it's really bad. But most people, when they see me, they don't know that I'm acting a lot. That makes sense?
Can you put on a drunk act?
Not really. I just don't... I find it distasteful. I don't really do that. Yeah, we need a distraction. I suppose I could do something.
No, I was thinking that, like, because I'm not that great at acting either, right? So that's what I was asking. But one of us, I was thinking you could act drunk. I'm carrying you. We could run into a staff member, and maybe you could, in a drunkenness, ask him weird questions. And I could be like, ah, dude, what are you doing? And then you'd be like, no, tell me where the brig is, whatever, right? And I'll be like, oh, sorry for him, sorry.
Okay.
For
no, okay, I got it.
You get what I'm
I can do that. I can do it. Let me try.
So you could play in the, I'll play straight, you play silly?
Yeah. You be the straight guy. Let's go.
Sure.
So you're kind of trailing along on the way back to Lydia's cabin, but looking for a staff member to run into?
Yeah, and like I will like kind of be supporting Rocco, and Rocco will be kind of like hanging off of me, and I'll be like, hey, we're almost there.
Okay.
And like Rocco can kind of like lean and stumble into one of the staff members, I guess, to really get his attention.
Okay. Heading back through the hall, the first class hall, back towards your cabins, there is a young man pushing a laundry cart along the hall.
Okay, perfect. What is your alias? You're Rex. Okay. Oh, shit. You sort of help push you stumble into the man and...
Oh, excuse me, sir. I did not mean to run into you. You see, I am quite inebriated at the moment, and I'm in a desperate need of being placed into a...
Rocco, what? Rex, inside voice.
Oh, I'm not very well. I think I need to go to the brig.
Easy, friend. You'll not want to be drunk like this out on decks. You fall in ocean, you know?
It is very hard to be on this ship. And it does rock me so. I wish that I would be put into the brig where I would be safe.
Sir, you should take friend to a cabin. Lay him down. Yeah. You're not going to be feeling very good.
The brig's not for us. We don't even know where the brig is.
Are we looking for the brig?
Why you keep talking brig? No one's going to arrest you. It's all right. You can be drunk here. Just be careful. Do not hurt yourself.
Oh, he's being silly. He thinks the brig is... I honestly can't tell what he's talking about sometimes. I think he half wants to go to the brig.
It sounds like such an interesting place. I've never been to one.
Both of you make a fast talk roll.
Man, I was a lot better at fast talking than my old character. Can I make a charm roll?
Yes. Okay. Yes, Rocco's fast talk should stand. Usually when
people are this drunk, I smell it on them. But friend, you don't have no smell at all. Why you're talking to me about Briggs so much?
That's a great question, friend. For reasons. You know, reasons. We all have them. We got them.
Raisins are in kitchen.
Yeah, not those type of reasons.
Emergency.
It's emergency. It's emergency. That's right. That's the story. It's an emergency. I need to.
You don't want to go to Brig.
I want
from,
to go
from
somewhere.
From what people are saying, very very bad man in Brig right now.
Who's that?
Don't worry. You should just stay clear.
Okay.
Even though I am not buying whole drunk act from you, I think maybe you should go to your cabin and go to bed.
Is that what I want to do? Maybe?
Is this... Are you two running like some sort of scam? You're trying to get... Like, I'm not carrying money. I don't know what the two of you are after.
My friend's an idiot.
Yes, very clearly. I'm just kidding with you. Of course, the passengers are always right.
Mm-hmm.
Is there? Okay. Let me ask you, Mr. Reasonable. Is there a reason you two are looking for a break? Never mind. Wait, I don't want to know. Are you looking for a break? Is that why you are accosting me in this way?
He was too embarrassed to ask it in a polite way. But he was curious where the brig was. I didn't want to go with this plan.
Right. Okay. So I'm right. This is all an act. You are just you're just looking for brig. I can tell you this much.
I'm sorry.
Brig is area where passengers is off limits for. There are many places on ship. First place passengers discouraged from going. First class passengers. Brig actually, you know, off limits, kind of private area. I could not possibly be convinced to tell you where Brig might be. There is no possible way. He's holding his hand out toward you.
Okay, I will put the $10 that I picked up from the night in there.
So you guys cashed out your chips, I imagine.
Yeah.
Well, as I said, he barely even looks at the bill as he slips it into his vest. I cannot tell you that the brig is on D-deck. I should not tell you at all that the brig is on almost lowest deck of ship. And pulling those up here.
Of course it is. That's exactly where I think it would be. Here's a poker chip for your troubles.
Thank you, friend. D-deck, you know, contains much storage. It contains steerage area and staff cabins, all places off limits, really, to your class of passenger. But I would never tell you, since I am not really permitted to do so, that in order to get to brig, you should go down steps toward the stern, toward the back of the boat. You would come up through an area where, in between steerage compartments, very close to rear stack, there is an area there where the Dorsey is private. That would not be the brig, if I were to tell you so.
That is so much detail. Thank you.
You've done a good job of maintaining the secrecy of this show.
Well, if I not tell you where it is, you might go there accident. But if I tell you, then you know where not to go. Yes.
It's a good thing because my friend's an idiot and he shouldn't be going there.
I should tell you also that always usually staff member there, acting as guard. You know, some take more seriously than others. Depending on who it is, they might not even be there. But be careful down there where steerage is. Many of those passengers looking for opportunities to take advantage of high-class, beautiful, well-dressed people such as yourselves. So just don't go there. and we will pretend that we never met.
Have a good night, sir.
Danya, comrade.
I will pick up some of the laundry that got knocked over when Rocco tumbled into him.
Thank you. No, no, sir. I take care of. Like, don't dirty your hands.
Well, have a good night, sir.
Yes, yes. Have a good night. Go to sleep. Yes. Go lay down in your cabin. Don't go anywhere that you shouldn't go.
Yeah, I will make a show of pushing Rex into one of our rooms, I guess.
Do you maybe just go into Lydia's room where Lydia and Dolores are?
I don't think we necessarily have keys for rooms that aren't ours.
No, you don't, but they're both there.
Oh, are they already
or
there?
Or do you just go into your room?
Let's go into Rex's room.
Okay. While you're doing this, Elaine, you went back to perform once more?
I think... Yeah, I guess. I don't know what else to do. So,
so you are?
I guess, yeah.
Okay. The band leader sees you come up, and he looks very excited and smiles at you. The song comes to an end, and he turns to his microphone. And he goes, ladies and gentlemen, once more we have the fabulous, beautiful passenger, Renee Lestrange, who has come back to do another song for you. Everybody, let's give it up for Renee Lestrange. Ms. Lestrange, what are you going to perform for us this time?
This is the cream in You're the Cream in My Coffee by Ruth Etting.
We know that one. All right. And a one, a two, a one, two, three.
Yes. Oh, yeah. That makes me happy.
An extreme success.
Yeah.
Heads turn as you begin to belt out You're the Cream in My Coffee by who?
Ruth Etting.
By Ruth Etting. People gambling stop gambling, and they turn to look, and a large portion of the room is mesmerized by your songbird-like performance. The song comes to a close, and applause erupts throughout the room. Ladies and gentlemen, Renee Lestrange! Woo!
I bow, or curtsy, rather.
Very nice. Very nice. Well done. Miss Lestrange, are you sure you're not a professional performer?
Just a hobby.
Just a hobby? Ridiculous. You should really get signed with someone. You know, we're having a Tahitian ball in a couple of nights. You should really sign up to perform.
I will give it a really good consideration. Thank you, friend.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's encourage Miss Lestrange to perform at the Tahitian ball.
Thank you, thank you.
And what are you going to do then? Are you going to head back to the room?
I guess I'll try and see if I can intercept them.
Well, they're already back up there, so.
Right, so I'll start walking towards the room and see if I can run into them.
Okay, so the four of you are in the room.
Five of us?
Well, she hasn't Elaine hasn't gotten there yet.
Oh, okay, yeah, okay.
So, Dolores, how is the room?
Oh, well, you know, it's been something. Mostly boring, but, you know. Do we have a plan? Do we know what's going on? When can we take care of Hubbard? I've been sitting here dying for details. Do you know what it's like to wait for everybody to come back and just tell you what's going on? And then I get this mysterious phone call. And honestly and frankly, I am ready to move. I feel stifled and isolated and lonely and...
I get it. You know, this is all strange for all of us. So we're just trying to make heads or tails of things, and it's really difficult.
I feel so out of place, and I'm concerned that I'll be discovered and somebody will have, like, you know, take issue, and then what happens to me? What if I got locked in the brig?
Well, we did find out how to get to the brig and a good point of access.
Oh, well, in that case, we don't have to, you know, but if we have to get a little bit of bait, Dr. Graw, I could be sent to the brig.
Well, preferably before. Not before.
It's a last-ditch effort. Well, the thing is that if I'm sent to the brig, Hubbard might be taken care of. Just like a last-ditch effort of, if I get caught, you know, slip me the equipment. That's what I'll say. Slip me the things that I need to take care of the job. And then
you think you could take on Hubbard by yourself?
With the amount of spite and hatred I have for that man? Probably. Plus, I know you can't tell, but I actually work out.
Okay.
Gotta stay fit.
I was gonna ask if you looked like you had a frame or if you were spindly.
Mm-mm. Hot boy hours. Real hot boy hours over here. Strong.
Floris's archetype is bon vivant.
When you're a pretty boy, it gets you a lot of places.
Okay, but yeah, I can explain sort of me as a player, John. A lot of that went over my head and I wasn't writing in the moment. But like I can explain how he was saying there was a good way of accessing through this one specific spot, and he was saying how some of the people on watch guarding the brig, some may be more diligent than others. So but yeah, was that too much in the moment? Sorry, what was that, Rocco? You kind of
What now?
Did you need a better setup?
Yeah, I don't know. I tried. I don't know. Something didn't work within me to actually make the performance happen. It was very strange. I my heart wasn't in it. I couldn't do it.
Damn, we both have 95s and you failed.
It was the first time I got to use that roll. Any sort, hoping for something to work, and it just didn't work at all. Yeah, I'm sorry, Michael. I promise I'll try better. I don't like being on this ship at all. All this is very confusing to me.
Yeah, don't worry. We'll have more chances. I think you were closer than you thought you were.
But really?
Maybe if you just had a bit more of a smell on you.
Yeah, it's true. I do actually smell very good. My breath smells like mint a lot more than it used to. Funny story.
You're not eating the powder, right?
The what now? Oh, you know about my powder. That's right. I might have talked about it. No, I don't eat
it. Might have talked about it. Yes, you might have talked about it. Okay, just...
I just never had access to it. Now that I do, I feel much better about myself. Thank you very much. It's a very important part of my routine now.
Dental hygiene is pretty important.
You're telling me. You know anybody who's a dentist? I need dentistry work.
No.
You don't know? Okay, you don't know any dentists. Okay. I just thought I'd ask.
No. Okay, but so potentially we could see if it might sound like there might even be nobody watching. If there is somebody watching, me and Rocco could run interference. So how's that sound to you two?
We'll say Elaine arrives now.
Hello?
Elaine's back. Hello.
Oh my gosh, girl. How'd your performance go?
First one, audio issues.
I'll have that.
It didn't go well. Second one, brought the house down. So.
Oh, girl. Yes. Yeah, you know. How do you?
Doing stuff. So what are you guys doing?
Well, Rocco and I figured out where the brig is and a good way of getting to it.
We're debating best tactics for murder.
No, it was
you know,
me and Rocco could interference. on if there's anybody there, and then you guys could get in, do your thing, get out.
And don't forget, sometimes all you need is a little money.
Also, it might be worth it to dress down a little bit going there. Just for what it's worth.
Are you looking at Elaine specifically?
Just all of us, except Rocco.
I already look like I work here. It's fine. I fit right in.
I'm in a simple linen suit. No. Should I take my watch off?
Oh, I mean, I have some spare clothes that look more, common.
Employee-ish?
I don't know if they necessarily look employee-ish, but they look more like on the streets.
Okay.
But yeah.
Am I with you?
I think.
Two groups of two, a group of two and a group of three. I don't know. Where do you want to fit in on this? Do you want to? I mean, you can go along.
I'll be a lookout.
Yeah, I was going to say, do we need anybody to. Does anybody want to maybe be the face if somebody gets inquisitive? Because everybody knows you party together.
Well, that's what I was suggesting we dress down. If we go, it's down below deck. So that's where both the staff and the lower class rooms are.
More or less likely to be recognized.
Yeah, especially if we blend in a bit more than we are right now. Wouldn't be recognizable. Less likely to get accosted too. The tip we got was that some of the lower class seats might be a bit more frisky to the higher class ones, so we'd attract less attention if we don't look like we have money.
Oh, that's fair. Yeah, why don't we just let's slum it a little.
I can do that.
You can keep your makeup, but maybe simplify your hair just a little bit. Go for a simpler gown. Simple, not even a gown, a dress. Perhaps pants.
You might want to wipe some of the makeup off.
I'll just take all the makeup off.
Okay.
I'm going to take it all off. I'm gonna
women of all classes would have worn it.
Yeah, take my hair down and put it in a low hairdo that is very bland and boring. I mean, I would imagine that Elaine without makeup would be unrecognizable in and of itself, especially if she looks all dressed down. So it's my Clark Kent.
I love that for you. So Elaine's dressed down. I'm borrowing some of your clothes.
Lydia,
everybody
can I borrow some of yours? I don't mean to be rude, but...
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, of course. I've got lots of practical items of clothing.
Yeah. I'm going to dress down. I'm going to carry my coat with me to put it on top so that as I transition down to the floors below, I can just take it off easily. But otherwise, I'm going to have something very plain. I'll pass the same thing on to Dolores. And that's also, my suggestion is maybe have, a transitionary piece so that we're not,
standing. Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, you can always tuck a silk scarf in your pocket anyhow. I can definitely dress up and down as needed.
Yeah, I think a coat is just an easy way to do that. That's my suggestion.
Take the rouge off, mess my hair about.
You look like a proper ruffian.
Thank you. I've seen them.
Okay. Well,
one of them does my gardening.
Do we want to go down deck then?
If you guys are ready.
Deck. Let us go below deck.
Let's go on down below then.
You going to take the elevators down or are you going to head for the stairs?
He suggested the stairs, right?
I believe so.
He said that there was stairs on that side, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I'm going to follow his suggestion. So.
Okay. So heading down the stairwells, down and down and around, you actually reach the point around B deck where Elaine was attacked by Hubbard. And does that have any effect on you, Elaine?
This is where he attacked me. Kind of weird.
How are you feeling?
That bastard.
Nice ears.
Thanks.
Yeah, I like it a lot.
I'm just slowly just... I'm going to be, like, fully invisible by the time the game ends.
Nice. So if you continue past... Oh, go ahead.
I would like to move on from this spot. I don't want to linger. That's all I was going to say, so...
So you continue past, you go on down until finally you find yourselves at a door on a stair landing. The stairs continue down, but the door says deck D. You have reached the level that the employee described.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Making sure we look appropriate. I guess me and Rocco can go out look first.
Let us.
Okay.
Can the two of you make a luck roll for me, please, both of you?
Oh my god, yes.
Oh, jeez.
Okay. A success and a failure.
He's so low.
Yeah, I died.
Oh well.
But that was a successful luck roll on Rocco's part. No crew members are in evidence where you are. As you peek through the door, you find yourselves in a long, dim hallway. The walls are like bare steel here. There is like ductwork and pipes running along the ceiling. There are dim lights along the way that are kind of flickering. There's a smell down here of faintly of diesel mixed with body odor. It's hotter down here. It's less climate controlled. But you don't see anyone.
Okay. Yeah, smells like work a man's cologne down here.
Yeah, and it's pretty much just the staff down here, right?
The staff quarters are up toward the front of the ship. If you look on D-Dex where those green places are. There's a lot of storage, the blue areas. The purple areas are steerage, where basically they throw the poor passengers and just keep them there.
Okay. And can you ping roughly like where the location for the brig was supposed to be?
Yeah, we're going to say this red area here right in front of the stack.
Okay. So we don't need to like go too far.
Right. There are hallways running through here that aren't depicted on the map.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, do we hear very much activity going on right now? It's like later in the night, right? So
it is. It's later on in the evening. Go ahead and make a listen roll.
Sure. Is my listening good?
Can I also listen? Or no, they're just in front, right?
Yeah, it's us in front.
Right.
I got a failure. What about you, Ryan?
I'll try it. Nope, I can't hear nothing.
You hear...
Spend 2 luck points.
Maybe there's a...
Yeah, I'll push.
Baby crying.
I mean, wait, I don't have any luck. Fuck that.
Somewhere. You can hear, actually, sounds of like the ship creaking, almost.
Mm-hmm.
You can hear the engines. They're just a deck below you. You hear the vibration, the hum of the engines. Beyond like the sound of a baby crying or, you know, there isn't a whole lot of human sound reaching your ears.
Okay. Well, we'll go forward to where the brig is, and you guys can like hang behind us just a bit, and we'll be like the canary, I guess.
Got it. That's good.
So you're moving ahead down the hall. Are the other three of you coming into the hall, or are you staying on the stair landing?
Maybe we come into the hall a little bit and like post up on, I don't know.
Well, we have to move towards the brig, right?
Yeah, so like we'll match distance, but we'll hang out on like, try and act natural, blend in.
Okay. So down here, almost at the lowest deck, strangely, it seems that almost you can feel the movement of the ocean more than you could up on the upper decks. You would think it would be the opposite, but down here, the swells and the rocking seems a bit more pronounced. And you know your characters. If any of you would be claustrophobic or have an issue with that, I'd like you to make a constitution roll if you think that would affect your character. Everybody feel okay about that?
I definitely don't think it would. I live on a houseboat.
Okay, that's fine.
Been on boats before.
Yeah, you have. That's right. Okay. As Michael and Rocco move forward down the hall and the rest of you trail behind, it's almost odd to you how little human activity there seems to be, even though the steerage compartments of these ships are usually jam-packed with people. Like, they should be very crowded areas. You're not hearing much, though. And actually, Michael, with your private investigator skills, make another listen roll for me.
Okay. It's another failure. 48 out of 42.
Do you want to improve that?
I'm thinking about it. Pushes my luck down to, that would push my down luck down to like 57. It's like quite a
6 points.
Oh yeah, so that would be 165. Sure, I'll spend 6 luck to make that a success.
You hear distantly, coming from somewhere behind you, perhaps, a soft, like, pinging sound, almost like hail hitting a tin roof. And it seems to be growing louder by the second. It seems to be getting closer.
It's coming from above?
You determine that it's coming from above and behind you. And as I said, there are pipes and ductwork and so forth running overhead, and you hear, and all of you can actually hear it at this point as it moves overhead. And between those of you in back and those of you in front, three fairly large dark shapes drop from the pipework. Everybody make a dexterity roll for me.
Nope.
That's a success for me.
Hard success.
Ooh, extreme success out of Dolores.
Everybody succeeded except for Rocco?
Yep.
Rocco, in front of you, behind you, and on top of you, three large rats fall from the piping and the ductwork and the ceiling. One of them actually lands on your shoulder. Now, Lydia, Elaine, and Rocco all had a bad experience with rats. Devin, you weren't there, but Lydia was.
It must be. I heard about it. Lydia told me.
Rocco, you actually died at the time beneath a swarm of rats.
Yep.
So I need the three of you to make a sanity roll, but Rocco, you need to make yours with a penalty. No, you weren't.
So.
Fail.
Rocco felt bad.
Yeah, I felt really bad.
No.
Mm-hmm. Lydia's okay. Elaine failed. Just a normal failure?
No point.
Well, they're not by degrees, but okay. Okay. Elaine, deduct 3 sanity points, please. Rocco, deduct 5 sanity points.
Mm-hmm.
As this happens, and the rats recover and scuttle off back into the darkness, the one jumps off of Rocco. But Rocco has stopped moving. Rocco is stopped in, dead in his tracks. His eyes sort of glaze over. His jaw gets slack. And Rocco, you are unresponsive.
Rocco. I'm going to give him a like.
Rocco, your vision is getting black from the edges and collapsing to a fine point, and everything is going dark. As this happens, you no longer see the hallway with your friends in front of you trying to snap you out of it. The scene that you're seeing is a very blurry one. You can almost only see perhaps a few inches or a foot in front of what's happening, but the scene that you're seeing is movement, moving forward. And there's a rounded surface beneath you that you're moving along. And then something large and furry kind of comes over your vision. And there are more of these objects around you. And it's almost as though you're seeing from the viewpoint of a rat in this swarm as it moves along. And it's moved past all of you now, but Rocco, your vision is moving through tunnels and along curves and down and over and a very convoluted path until suddenly the scene sort of opens up into a large dim space. It appears to be filled with crates and boxes. And suddenly the movement stops. And all of these scurrying shapes around you sort of burst off in different directions. As in front of you, there's the large shadowy shape of a man. Again, it's very blurry to you. You can only see a very close area. But this man's shape lowers down to look at you, and it's a face you don't recognize. But as it does, a large hand comes directly toward your vision. You find that perhaps you have some agency in whatever is happening to you. Do you wish to try to do anything?
Rocco will try and struggle or get away.
Make a dexterity roll.
Ooh.
With an extreme success, your point of view turns abruptly, and you find that there is a great deal of dexterity in whatever avatar you're seeing through. And as it begins to move quickly in the opposite direction, the fingers of this hand come down over your point of view from behind. And as they do, they seem to dissolve into small shapes, which begin to drop down off of it. Shapes that have many legs, that have mandibles and antennas. And as your point of view retreats, these things fall down onto it and completely cover it. Everything goes black. Now, the rest of you who are trying to revive Rocco.
Has he done this before?
Elaine is freaking out over this because she was also involved in the rats situation, and largely probably the reason that Rocco died was because she came back, or he came back for her. As a last ditch effort, Elaine is going to try and kiss him.
Aww. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. See if it'll bring him out of it. Come on, man.
As you do, Rocco's eyes flutter. And Rocco, the darkness is gone. And Elaine is right there.
Quiet.
What happened?
Quiet.
You were out.
Some rat fell on us.
What fell on us?
There's a rat. Like,
oh, what?
It fell on you, and then you kind of just passed out.
Okay.
Are you okay?
I saw some weird stuff. It's funny you should mention rats. It's just like bugs and all sorts of horrible things.
Take a couple seconds.
Ooh.
Breathe.
I don't want to be down here anymore. This Rocco, place is... Yeah.
I need you to make another sanity roll, please.
Ooh.
Yes!
That's as good as it gets.
Yes!
Regained back some for that.
Wow, we have like had such swings in this night.
I know.
I've not felt so clear about something in my life in a while.
You feel as though some part deep inside of you, some part of the rat's essence perhaps was left behind.
I think I feel a kinship here. Something's going on. But this all feels very natural to me now.
What?
Nothing. It's nothing. I don't want to be down here right now. I don't think any of us should be down here right now.
No. Yeah. That's why we should try to get it done.
Oh, yeah. The thing.
We were in the middle of the thing.
Okay, yeah, whatever, fine.
You gonna be okay?
I don't know. I'm feeling okay, but it's all very strange. Just do the thing. Please, do the thing.
If we need to do, you know, our act, can you? Is this gonna make worse? You need to act drunk. You're halfway there. Okay, let's go. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
You continue along the hall.
Somewhat quietly.
You go past the steerage compartments, and the doors are open. It's filled with bunks crammed tightly together, and just large numbers of people, and just too many people in very close quarters. You pass an area where there are a lot of, it looks like Chinese passengers all together. There are other sections where it looks like maybe, a bunch of Irish are together. You can hear people murmuring. They take notice of you, but no one approaches you. And you continue down the hall until you find the door marked private that the staff member had intimated perhaps was the brig.
Okay, I think this is it. I will shuffle back. Well, actually, can I do a scan to see if there's if it looks like it's clear right now? Like, nobody would be here.
Yeah, make a spot hidden to look around.
Hard success. 38 out of 105.
Closer to the steerage compartments here, you can hear the murmur of people a little more, but nobody follows you. Further up the hall, toward the where you think the staff cabins are, the hallway kind of bends away, so you can't actually see the area where the cabins are. Yeah. No one is evident in the hall.
Okay. I think we have an opening. There's nobody here.
Before we go any further, I did want to just mention that I think it's safe to say that Elaine would have grabbed like her stuff that she normally brings from the room. Mm-hmm.
I was thinking we might need to open up a locker.
Yeah. I meant to say it earlier, but then,
you
like...
You were grabbing your stuff, right? I think so.
Yeah. But we could try the handle before we... Because that thing looks alien and weird to old people, so... The locksmith-o-matic.
Does it seem like the handle is locked?
Who's trying it?
I'll try it.
Make a luck roll.
Ooh.
Good thing I didn't volunteer. Oh.
Failure.
Shouldn't have said anything.
The door's not locked. The handle turns. And suddenly the door is pulled open before you. And there is a crew member. What? Who are you folks? You're not supposed to be down here. Did you get lost?
My friend was looking for Privy. He's...
Are you with the steerage? Doing...
Also, we wanted to report that we saw some rats.
Yeah, okay. Thanks. Tell me something I don't know.
Are what you... kind of... nudge Rocco in the stomach. Come on.
I was wondering if I could get the full tour. You got the full tour down here?
No, you're not supposed to be. What deck?
Where is your cabin? On?
What?
What class are you? Are you here with?
What class am I? That's a silly question.
He's gonna throw up soon.
I'm going to throw up a lot.
Shit.
I just telling you the boat and the liquor together. All right,
there's a water closet in here. I'm not supposed to let you in. Come on, come on, hurry up. I don't want to have to clean this up. And he shows you where the water closet is. Okay. He brings you into the room where he was seated at a desk. There's a water closet behind him, and there is another door. Kind of straight through the room from where you came in. It's a steel door. It's got a tiny window in it, and it's clearly got bars in the window. That door's closed. Hurry up. Do what you're going to do.
I'm going to vomit in here. Just give me it. I'm going to go
vomit on him.
Please hit the commode.
I'm going to... Rocco's going to expel whatever's in his stomach.
On him. Please.
On him?
Yes. Please, on him.
Whatever you want. I'm not going to make you roll for that.
Okay.
Is it a con saving roll? Because I can't keep my constitution together.
I'm so sorry.
Oh, that's a lot of liquid. Shit. That makes sense. I haven't had much to eat, and I should have.
What is happening? All right, look. Finish what you got to do in the water closet. I gotta go change.
Shit. I will do that. Some thank you.
Don't just leave. When you're done, just leave, okay?
Okay.
He doesn't touch anything. I'm so sorry.
And you hear him just making that noise the whole way down the hall as he heads back toward his cabin to change.
That almost always works.
That was artful.
I could do it again, maybe.
No, I mean later.
I think you're good.
Anyone else feeling nauseous now?
I feel bad, but
you guys gotta do your thing. I'm gonna keep an eye out on the thing. So me and Rock will run interference in case anything happens.
I'll come with you guys, but I think that honestly, Elaine's got the majority of the power here.
Well, I gave Lydia the perfume.
Oh, I suppose, yeah.
I mean, it was Lydia, but you went to, right?
But I can go with Lydia. Well, I don't really want to trigger Hubbard either, so that's why I kind of don't want to go down there. Well, that's
my thing. It's like, on the one hand, I want to take his ass out face to face, but on the other hand, I don't want him to see my face. Because what if he does have feelings and tries to raise some sort of alert?
But I am, like, all dressed down, so I look totally different than any other scenario that he's seen.
You also brought your lullaby, right?
I did.
Yeah, like, I don't know, just fucking unload on him.
All right. So, Lydia has the perfume, I have the lullaby, so we can try both and see what happens, I guess.
All right.
I mean...
So, let's try the lullaby first, because the hensbane is a limited resource. I really want to... When we get down there, I want to start, like, really creepily singing. Like, maybe, like, I ain't got nobody or something like that. And
I'll solid choice.
And get ready to point it at him.
Okay. What are you going to do? So what are y'all going to do?
Oh, we're going to head towards the cells or whatever?
Yeah, and me and Rocco are going to keep... We're going to be at the front to make sure nobody comes in and keep an eye out.
Actually, maybe I shouldn't sing. I don't want people to alarm or alert people to our presence. I won't do that. I just wanted to be creepy. Weird.
So you're going to try the seal door?
Yeah. So there's a steel door, there's the water closet, and there's a door.
You came into the room. In the room, there's a desk. Directly across from where you came in, there's the steel door. And then the water closet's to your right.
So yeah, we'll go to the steel door.
And there's vomit everywhere.
Sneakily, I guess. I don't know.
The steel door is locked.
The door's locked?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you know what your girl's gonna do. She's gonna pull out that locksmith. Or lockpick-o-matic, that's what I called it. And so I now make a locksmith roll.
There was a mechanical repair roll and a locksmith roll involved. I think the mechanical repair dictated what type of success you needed with the locksmith roll.
I think that's for the infrared heat scanner.
Oh, is that the wrong thing?
I put in the description.
Oh,
you just have
locksmith with a bonus roll with this.
Well, it's at 70 now.
It increased your locksmith roll.
Yeah, okay. I didn't have any before. So
I'm glad we have to go have this discussion every single time. I should write this down. Okay.
Okay, I rolled a regular success.
Okay. So you press the thing to the lock, and everyone hears the little things and the tumblers and the door creaks open towards you slightly.
Okay. I will open it as quietly as possible. And we're in.
The door opens.
Do I hear anything?
The door opens to a small space, about 5 feet deep into this room, and the cell is right there. There are bars, ceiling to floor, behind which there's a cell which is like 6 feet by 6 feet. Hubbard is laying on the cot, which is against the far wall. And when the door opens and you come in, he sits up and looks. And he sees you, and he squints, because...
I'm going to turn my head, kind of.
Did everyone else come in as well?
I'm hanging back in Shadow Town, but I do have the spritz armed and ready.
I'm going to just not waste any time.
Who the fuck are you?
Use the lullaby.
All right. What's the range on the lullaby?
Oh, good question.
It's audio, right? It's a thing you sing into it, so.
I sing into it. I've done it to someone like 30 feet away.
He's so. Only like 6 feet away.
Yeah.
So opposed constitution rolls, correct?
I believe sing roll opposed with constitution roll.
Okay, you make a sing roll.
Extreme success.
Oh, geez.
Oh, here it is. So, in the middle of him saying, what is it, a fucking shift change or something? You're not the same. And he crumples to the floor.
Okay, he's asleep for 9 minutes. Lydia, you're on. Go.
Lydia runs up. 1-2 spritz.
No spritz. Oh, I thought you were going to do the tide thing.
Yeah, magic him.
Oh.
You're going to choke him.
This took so much less work, y'all.
Yeah, but like if he drowned, there's no slip.
All right. Fine. He's going to drown. I don't know.
He could drown on a drink easy.
He's way more likely to drown if he's sleeping.
Yeah. Alrighty.
Especially if he like vomits.
Yeah, I mean, choking on your own vomit and seawater is great. Lee, what do I roll?
Okay. You're going to cast Breath of the Deep?
Yes.
Okay. Deduct 8 magic points. Mm-hmm. The spell takes a little bit of preparation. So how long did you say he's out for?
9 minutes.
Okay. So for about half of that, you're preparing the spell. You're summoning the necessary energy from the cosmos to help you cast this spell.
I also have the trinket that Dr. Soong gave me.
Well, if you want to use that, there's more involved.
Oh. All right. I mean, I guess we'll try it for... If he's out for 9 minutes, I guess we can try for round one.
Well, I will tell you this. He is not able to oppose you.
Oh, okay. Then, yeah, we'll just do it.
The spell's an automatic success.
Okay.
Do you do anything to cast it? Is there any flair you'd like to?
No, she's kind of all business right now, so it's not.
Okay.
She's not a magician.
So right? You're whispering some eldritch words.
Yeah.
After having
the
prepared.
The crazier, the better.
Okay. So as he's laying on the floor, you see his body convulse, and you hear him start to cough, and suddenly. A pool forms under his head. He's laying sort of face down, but facing you. It's like he's drooling a lot. And then suddenly, in his sleep, he coughs, and a great gout of water pours forth from his mouth. And you can smell the brininess of it. This is clearly seawater being expelled. And it isn't like he just coughs and it comes out. All of a sudden, it's gushing out of him like a spigot has been turned on. It's coming out of his nostrils. It's coming out of his mouth. It's just flowing out onto the floor, and the entire floor of the cell is beginning to, fill with this seawater that just keeps coming out of him. And you can hear him in his sleep sort of choking against it, but there's nothing he can do. Do you stand there and just watch him die?
Yeah.
What are we supposed to do?
We gotta make sure the job is finished, right?
Anybody else like, watching him die?
If you want. I'm just gonna
Would it behoove us to move on before what's his face gets back though?
I'm just standing there like staring at it like a child stares at a worm, right? Like yeah. Wow. And I get out a flask and like take a swig and then hand it to him. Like we can hang out a little.
Intervene.
We can hang out a few more moments.
No, I think it's time to go. No, because we don't know how quick Mr. Vomit's gonna change.
Do we have to? She's gonna have to be like pulled off like a 7-year-old. So
okay, I can pull off a 7-year-old. I've got one.
Perfect.
Now, Lydia, the casting of the spell costs you 6 sanity points.
Woo! Oops, sorry, I did not mean to roll over those things, but I'm doing very well.
Deduct 6.
Yeah.
Who all is watching him die?
I am not. I was in the room. Pull Lydia away.
Okay, so you're not going to stick around until he stops breathing.
I mean, as much as I would
like
to bask in the glory of the end of his life, no, I don't want to get caught down here.
Okay. Well, then you're all just going to leave?
Yeah.
If he's dead.
You're going to wait for him to die? No, nobody wants to watch him die.
Well, no,
I already volunteered to, but they're pulling me off of this little stuff.
Me and Rocco are waiting, right? So, like, you guys are saying...
Well, I mean, what do y'all think that we should... do, though? Like, should we stay and make sure that he's dead?
I mean, unless you wanted me to put a bullet at his head, you know, you gotta stick around until the body count ticks.
I mean, if we
know that Lydia would know if her spell worked, right? So...
I think
as you stand there arguing about this, you hear a final
oh, thank goodness.
And the sound of the rushing water seems to lessen as it's just slowed to sort of a leak coming out of his blue lips.
All right, now let's go quick. I don't want to get
a death rattle, don't you?
Yeah, well, I do love a death rattle in this particular situation, not typically. Can we go?
All right. Oh my goodness, kitten, what is it?
Just trying
to yeah, so I guess we'll mosey out of there. I will relock the door.
Okay.
Love it.
How quick is that thing? I forget.
The lockpick?
Yeah.
You should take the time to lock the door.
Within a few seconds, probably. It's not going to take it long to...
Okay.
Like, locate all the proper tumblers.
Yeah,
it's not like a big blast us.
Okay, I relock it.
Go ahead and roll. Roll your lockpick again.
Oh, sorry. Success, 56 out of 70.
Okay. You relock it easily enough. Do you do anything about the vomit on the floor?
Ooh.
From Morocco?
Mm-hmm.
Is there anything we can clean it up with?
Some seawater is leaking out from under the steel door.
Let's just get out there. Let's leave. Let's go. Let's move as quickly as possible, but in a lake.
Okay, you guys go first. We'll be trailing behind you in case the guy comes back.
Love it.
So let's go. Guys.
All right, girls.
Time to go to casino night. I'm feeling lucky.
Out in the hallway, you see spatters of Rocco's vomit on the floor leading down the hall where the so where the crew member had fled.
Oh, don't you just love to see it?
So Michael and Rocco are coming up behind and closing the door to the office.
Yeah, we'll close it behind us, and they go before us.
Who's last?
Me and Rocco.
Which of you is like the furthest back? Like, are you're just kind of together closing the door?
Well, which do you want to take the back, or should I take the back?
You take the back, since I'm basically vomiting and not okay. Great. So you go ahead.
All right, then Michael, make a luck roll for me.
I make a luck roll.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Oh, geez.
Not lucky tonight.
As you're closing up the office, the crew member comes back in a fresh uniform. He's like, hey, okay, you folks are leaving? Okay, good. You didn't touch anything, right?
No, but we didn't have anything to clean up the mess. Sorry.
I want to get close to your friend.
Sorry, I'm trying to get him out of here.
What deck are you staying on again? What?
Look, I feel so bad here. I'm going to pull out a 10, and I'm like, I'm so sorry for all of this.
Yeah, I can't take that.
What do you mean you can't take this? We threw up on you.
I can't.
Or he threw up on you. Please, I feel so bad about this.
Make a charm roll.
Yes! Dream success.
What are these rolls?
Gingerly takes the 10. He's like, all right, just get your friend to bed or to the hospital or something, all right?
Yeah, we're going. Sorry.
All right. And he opens the door, and as you head back up the hall, you hear, what the?
Oh, jeez, Louise.
Please don't make me vomit on command anymore. I don't want to do it. I think I want to retire from this.
Oh, my God. You know, I don't blame you.
It's so useful.
As the vomit is now swirling in a pool of seawater.
Oh, that's gross.
Oh, is it just like...
The water's leaking out from under the door. Yeah.
Did you just turn him into a faucet?
Abrasion, not our problem.
I'm glad you didn't say what deck you were on or anything.
Oh, my God.
Money! Hey, I'm going to use that charm.
You know what? Yeah.
Okay. So, yeah, we go back up, right?
Let's go to our rooms.
Yeah. Lay low for the evening.
Enough adventure for the evening.
So you're all heading back to your individual cabins?
Well.
Sure.
I'm hanging with whomstever.
It's really true, you don't have a cabin.
These cabins don't have like single beds, do they? Do they have doubles? Or like not double beds, but are there two beds in these rooms? Or
no, they've we're gonna say they've got like queen size beds.
Okay.
Right. We do know from experience though that a woman should not stay in a room with a man unless they're married. Right? Because that was with the Chadwick and his Virginia.
Would it be more appropriate then for you gals to stay together?
Well,
probably.
I share a room with me or Rocco.
Well, that would put. Yeah, I suppose. Who wants what?
Technically, nobody should know that you're here, right? So.
I mean, that's true. Who's got the largest room? Most well appointed.
Michael and Elaine both have balcony rooms.
I probably can't really use the balcony if somebody can see me from it. Oh, I mean,
I've got it. I've got an armchair. If you don't want to share a bed, I can take the chair.
No, I wouldn't want to put you through that. I'm the one who just came up out of nowhere.
Anyways, my room's large.
All right, I'll come stay with you. I'll make a bed on the floor. It's not my first time.
And I probably have extra clothes too you could use. I don't think.
I bought some clothes.
I bought some clothes. I bought a sketchbook. Like, oh, I've okay. been up and on the ship,
oh,
but
you
like.
Bought some. I thought you yeah. said you brought.
No, and no, 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 no.
How'd you bring it? You just.
I just keep a, you know, I keep a towel and a backpack at all times. No, I bought some.
Okay.
I was well. Up on the deck earlier today.
But yeah, so you guys. He's.
Yeah, should this be bedtime?
So everyone goes to their own cabins then. Dolores goes with Michael. Rocker, sure. You feel this pit within you where this sort of rat-like essence seems to have settled. Gross. And you feel an odd connection that wasn't there. You don't know if it's something you care to explore, but there's a weirdness inside of you.
Become the Rat King.
Michael, as you and Dolores head into your room, you discover that your phone is ringing.
Well, I'm not going to answer it.
We're going to say it's around 10 o'clock at night right now.
I will pick it up. Listen for half a second.
Okay.
And then say hello.
Hello, Mr. Faraday.
Who's this?
Dr. Soong again.
Oh, okay.
I'm terribly sorry to trouble you. I wonder if I could impose upon you and your friends to help me with an extremely sensitive matter.
How so and how soon?
I know it's getting terribly late, but immediately, if you wouldn't mind, my servant Wang Ma has been murdered, and I am missing some artifacts, and that's where we're gonna stop for tonight.
Okay.
I love this game. You guys are so much fun.
Yay.
So, whew, that was kind of crazy.
Those rolls, though. Like, seriously.
Can we talk about 8859 versus 895? Yeah. That's fun for me.
So, well done, guys. You murdered someone. It's your first
I
murder.
I love doing the murder.
We unalive someone.
Oh, that absolutely is funny.
We did unalive someone.
I didn't notice how, like, the numbers are so similar, but mm-hmm. flipped. Yeah, that's kind of funny.
I thought that was fun.
So, yeah.
Ooh, okay. Love it. Love okay. it. Alex Hubbard is dead, and so is, what's the name of the assistant?
Wang Ma.
I mean, supposedly he's dead. And it's not like he hasn't been doing time weird time travel shenanigans either, so.
Oh, Alex.
Well, this version of him is dead.
So,
thank
you for watching. We will be back on Friday with Legends of the Silent Three, 7 p.m. Pacific. And after that, on Monday, as always, Descent into Avernus, right? It is Valentine's Day, though, so it might be a short session.
There may be some odd disturbances, but from the sounds of it, we're going to be missing one person right now. So...
Okay.
Yeah, I don't think I'll have to back out and think about it. But I said I think I might be able to stay the whole session. I'll have to figure it out.
Yeah.
And then we will be back to find out what happened to Wang Ma and Dr. Soong's items on February 23rd. So, thanks for watching. Good night, everybody.
See you then. Good night, Internet.
Good night, Internet.
Good night.